Mini Connells right there up on Broadway. Pull me back to that McDonald's. Back to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a famous whipping pastry. Cruising down A Street, off white Lexus. Driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm out there. Hey, everyone. Beautiful Saturday. Thought I'd get some ideas worked out and just kick back, relax, and enjoy the day. A couple of days ago, I was watching a video on Ebomi's B&E Brew Review channel, and he had Christopher from Alone with Company with him. Well, that's an interesting pair right there. Anyway, they got around to talking about the SBR pistol that Christopher's got. I don't know if he just built it or just put the new trigger in, but he was showing Eric the binary Fostec Echo trigger, and he had put it in his pistol. It got me thinking about my latest encounters with my SBR. I don't know if you guys remember last year, I did an SBR build with an Adams Arms short barrel upper. And if you recall the video, this doesn't look anything like what it used to. Well, it kind of looks like it, but a lot of stuff is missing. There's no bolt carrier or bolt carrier group. Trigger assembly is still in there. This is the binary BFS trigger from Franklin Arms. No piston system in here. I started pulling this whole thing apart because I was fed up with the piston system from Adams Arms that came on this upper. You can see that this is quite short. It's a 7.5-inch barrel, and the gas port is right there, right where my thumb is. So from there to there, exceedingly short dwell time for a piston system to accommodate. And Adams Arms didn't really stand up to the task. Even though they built the system, it was horrible. I mean, Picatinny style gas block that they use on the system only has 3 gas adjustments, all of which still funnel some gases back into the chamber. There's no front venting of any kind of gas. So basically, you turn down the system to a suppressor mode and it just sends more gas back into the chamber. And I tell you, it looked worse than a lot of DI guns that I had before. So I pulled it off. I'm going to put another Superlative Arms gas block system in there, a piston system. It's going to have close to 30 adjustable points that you can set gas settings to. And then the obvious advantage to it is that it's got a patented front gas port that discharges excess gas out the front of the rifle and not back into the chamber. So that should help with some of the issues I was having with the trigger, which was obviously bolt follow. I got it down to pretty close to reliable, almost 100%. But I wanted to see if I could do better. So what I'm going to do is change out the gas block system, and I'm waiting for Superlative Arms is coming out with a low mass bolt carrier, which should work really well in the system. I'm also waiting on BFS Gen 3, which I might put that in this and move this to an AR-15 build I've got going. I haven't decided yet, but you know, with Fostek's Echo Trigger coming out, it's gained a lot of popularity, and I started looking at it and it decided it wasn't applicable because those are made for direct impingement guns and they don't function for piston weapons out of the box. You have to either, the only thing you can do is take your bolt carrier and machine it with the required notches in, and then it'll function. But the end result is you paid for a bolt carrier, which is part of the price of the kit, that you're never going to use. And I find that an excess of $80 that you could use on other parts as opposed to just having it sit in a bolt carrier you're never going to use. So I'm sold on Franklin's BFS trigger. Now, other parts that, the other thing about it is when you go with Adams Arms gas piston systems, you're locked into only a couple of handguards, one of them being Samson's EVO, which isn't a bad deal. I mean, I'm getting rid of this because I'm not going to have a Picatinny. I'm going to have a low profile gas block on the new system. But if I wanted to, with Superlative Arms, I could use almost any handguard setup that I'd want because it doesn't require the stock barrel nut on the barrel. So I started purchasing parts, and one of the parts, finally getting to the topic of this, sorry, I get sidetracked easy. I bought, and I'm sure a lot of you will recognize that, it's a Battle Lynx MFT buttstock. I had taken off the Magpul ACS that I had on there, which comes in at over 14 ounces. And Battle Lynx is less than half of that. So, you know, an opportunity to pick up 7 ounces is not taken lightly, so I went ahead with it. And I actually like the look of it. It's a cleaner look. So I was made, the only mistake that I made was where I purchased this. And the reason for this video is it's, you know, I'm sure a lot of people are already aware, but I was not aware that there are knockoffs being sold on eBay from China. And when you go looking for the bargain basement prices, you are in the China syndrome, and I was not aware of it. So I went ahead and bought this MFT for about $40 with free shipping. And my first insight as to it being a troubling issue was the box it came in. It did not come in the original package. Came in a brown, nondescript, generic box. And then the biggest red light that caught my attention is made in China. Yeah. But it's real easy to tell even before you look at that. While it looks almost identical, you know, it's got all the everything's right down to the T on this thing, except, I don't know if you can hear it. For those of you that have Battlelinx stocks, you know that they don't make that noise. It's it's a very tight fit on a genuine one, so that is your biggest indicator that you've got a bogus Battlelinx. So I filed a complaint on eBay, and it kind of worked out okay for me because I just got a notification that I got my refund, and they didn't even ask for this one back, so I got a free, albeit bogus, Battlelinx MFT stock, which I can probably use. I mean, it, you know, get used to the rattle, it, I don't know, it works. I mean, everything else works on it. No, just it's that rattling in your ear. So I just wanted you to all be aware, if you haven't had a run-in yet with it, there's frauds on everything that are popular out there. And I think it's just sad that, you know, if somebody's going to sell something like this, they should, say, Battlelinx lookalike or something, I don't know. But when they're outright trying to swindle you, that kind of pisses me off. So anyway, I think I kept this shorter than what I usually do. Hopefully I did. Anyway, I'm going to go out and have a nice cold beer and enjoy the rest of this beautiful Saturday afternoon. It's about 80 degrees here today. So everybody have fun. Be safe.